Hello and welcome back. Welcome back to part 2 of Exploration Guide. And here we'll learn how to hack, what skills and modules are important for hacking, what sites are good for hacking and what sites are not, and some defense versus gankers if we go in low sec or wormhole space. Now, as you can see, I am on a relic site. Just scan it. And I'm hovering over a container that needs to be hacked. To hack this container, you first need to lock it. Let's lock it. Lock target. Now, usually first you wanna know what's inside, so we will scan to see if it's good for hacking. Well, it's not good, but we'll still hack it for learning purposes. Now, because it's a relic, we'll use a relic analyzer. So, here it is. When you try to hack a container, a game like this, a mini game like this appears. And you need to find the core and kill it. Now, from here we start and we click on the first node, and the first node will send us a number. In this particular case, it's 2. That means that somewhere around here, a 2 nodes distance, here, here, or here, or here, there is something good along the way. Something good, that means tools that will help you hack better. I'll put a picture on what tools can you get. Now, this number can specify if the core is near. So, if some, let's click it like this, 1. So here, here, or here, or here, oh. Can be the core, but and a good thing, a good tool to, along the way, while you hack, core is usually around here. While you hack, you'll find firewalls and defensive system that will prevent you to hack this container. I'll put a picture with the firewalls so you'll see what I mean. Now, you don't need to panic. I'll put a link from Wiki University in the description down below with this with this information also. Okay, now there is a particular node that we may find that is a glowing node, that it's a 50% to give us a good thing, that means a tool, or 50% to give us a bad thing, that means a defensive system. So let's hack it. Now let's see what node give us the tool, because it's around here. You see, this is a utility system. It repairs. If you click on it and click 1 node, 2 nodes, it repairs our life. Now, when you must kill the core or a defensive system, you have this coherence. We may call it as simple as life. And this is the damage or the virus strength that we have. Now let's find a defensive system. Look, this is a defensive system. It's a firewall. And it has 40 life, 20 damage. And if we click on him, he makes us 20 damage. We give him 25. And another click and we kill him. Okay. Another tool. We take the tool. Let's kill this. And here is the core. It looks like this. This is a basic one. Have 50 life, 10 damage. Click one, click two, and we finish the hacking. Now let's loot our precious cargo. Well, it's not so precious, but we'll loot it anyway. Now I'll show you the skills and modules that you need for hacking. When hacking, archaeology gives us 10 plus 10 virus coherence per level. That means it will give us 30. And here is for data, same. Plus 10 virus coherence per level. That means 30. This gives are give to us by skills. And let's look at our ship. Relic analyzer and data analyzer give us also coherence and damage. Let's put show info attributes. Virus strength 25, and here it tells us the maximum that we have when we enter, because when we hack we already have 80 and 25. If we look on the data show info, you'll see that we have 17 and 25. This reason is because we put this small gravity, this small emissional scope sharpener that, if we put info, gives us to relic 10 life bonus. And there is one for data also, but relic are more valuable, so it's better to have more life. Now, here in high sec, you don't need any strategy, you just go. Now let's go to another cargo and hack it. And scan it from so we know. Now, because this is for learning purposes, we'll hack all three. It has some loot. But usually in high sec you don't find that good loot. Okay, now that we are orbiting, let's hack it. Now, because it's so easy, we go to the end and we find the core. Now, because it's low sec, this table is small, but when you go in low sec and wormhole space is bigger and has a lot of gaps around. Now there is a rule called rule of six. The rule of six means that whenever you click a node surrounded by six other nodes, here you are sure you won't find a defensive system. Now, you won't, if you go in wormhole space, you won't find many rule of six in these tables, because are those tables are filled with many gaps and are very hard to hack. So you need there to use some kind of strategy. But when I was learning at first, I hacked every cargo I found just to make a habit to know how to hack it faster, because it was some kind of training for a bigger goal. And let's hack it again. Now, you have to know, let's loot it. You have to know that these, the sites that you found while exploring and scanning, not all are good sites to go and hack. You see, here this site is called Crumbling Relic Site. Well, I don't have the... Here, you'll see what the site it's called, and here you'll see the kind of pirates there are. There is a table that will show you the pirate, the angel, I think, the angel pirates have smaller loot in containers, and the Serpentis and Shasa, I think, they have the biggest loot in containers when you find, or in data, or in relic. Now, I'll show you a picture on the screen that shows where it's safe to go and hack, and no NPC will come and blow you up. And same, the link you'll see in the description down below. It's from EVE University Wiki, as always. And while I was scanning, trying to make this video, if you look at my loot, I stumble at a ghost site because I was a little careless. Thinked all sites on HiSec were safe. I gone there and hacked the first can or the first cargo and got this and some other loot, more loot than natural for high security space. And after I hacked it, the music changed and I knew there were pirates incoming. This blueprint is like 10 million. You can find good stuff in high security if you are careful. And after this, I'll show you how I did it, because it was recorded. It's not a big deal, but and so on. You'll see a lot of hacks from my past, either on my main or on this character, that are hard and have some more good loot than few hundred isk. Now, the last part here that I want to talk about when hacking is when you hack in low security space or in wormholes. When you hack, you are most vulnerable to get killed or blown up your ship. So there are certain things you can do while you hack. Let's go. First of all, always orbit 500. No afterburner or microwarp drive on. It must be off, because when it's off, you have a faster line time, so you can warp. Orbit is this. Because I saw a lot of explorers that just approach this cargo and sit there while hacking. When you are sitting, you will die fast if someone comes to gank you. Now, while hacking, let's hack. You have this window up here. You can put it whatever you like. You can put it here, you can put it here. I keep it like this, so I have the D-scan on, so I can scan always. And here to see, usually it's not so noisy when you are in Warhol or low sec, like this. And you see the red ship pop up. Now, the elite players that gank relics, you will not get away from them. But the rest of them, you'll have a chance. Now let's hack it pretty fast so we don't lose time. Here is the tool. Now you see I'm pretty careless while hacking because this is... You'll see in a little bit how hard hacks can be. This is the ghost site I was telling you about, and if you listen to the music carefully, it will change after the first hack, and when it changes, that means the NPC pirates are coming in. So I warped off. Here it is, and the failed hack. For private reason, I covered all up except the window for hacking and for looting. Did something wrong happened when rule of six appeared in wormholes? Man, this sucks. Oh, crap. this is a failed hack. In this hack I found great loot, almost 100 million ISK. One note you keep in mind is that when you hack, you'll see the loot change in your ship's inventory a lot. This is the end of our video.
Hope you like it.
And if you haven't seen the part 1, I'll leave a link in the description down below. See you next time.